Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have discussed about the male reproductive system. Today, we will discuss about female reproductive unit. This is the diagram of female reproductive unit. It starts with ovary. These ovaries are located on each side of the lower abdomen. And the shape is almond-like. These ovaries are attached with the wall of uterus by the help of this ligament. After this ovaries, next is this fallopian tube. This fallopian tube is expanded in the form of this funnel-shaped structure. This funnel-shaped structure is called infundibulum. And at the base of this infundibulum, these finger-like projections are present. These are called fimbri. And this is long fallopian tube, starting from here up to this point. Inside this ovary, female gamete is produced, and these fimbri, the function of these fimbri is to collect the produced female gamete. That is the secondary oocyte. This infundibulum part opens into ampulla, and ampulla opens into isthmus. To understand this, we will see another diagram. These are the ovaries. This funnel shaped part is infundibulum. These finger like projections are fimbri. Infundibulum opens into this part, that is ampulla. Ampulla opens into this isthmus. We can also see all these parts in this diagram also, where the blue one are fimbri. Next to this, this part is infundibulum, this green part is ampulla, next to ampulla is isthmus. Fimbri collect the secondary oocyte produced inside the ovaries. This ampulla is actually the site of fertilization. Here the fertilization takes place. This fallopian tube opens into uterus. This whole part is uterus. Uterus is divided into further parts, like upper part is termed as fundus or the fundic part. This part is termed as body part. And after this body part, it has cervix. This body part has outer fibrous perimetrium wall, middle smooth muscular, made up of smooth muscles, myometrium, and inner highly vascular with full of blood supply, endometrium. This cervix is a very narrow part. It opens inside this uterus through internal os opening and open outside into vagina through external os means opening. So this is how the cervix appear. It has this internal opening, internal os, and this is external opening or external os. So this is the site of implantation. This endometrium, where the placenta formation take place, and these myometrium, which are made up of muscles, help in the parturition. This is the vagina. The cervix opens into vagina. The walls of this vagina are highly folded. It opens outside through vulva. Vagina is also called colpus. Walls are highly folded. It has bacteria, mainly lactobacilli. These are generally termed as vaginal bacteria, which are acidic in nature. In previous class, I have already explained in case of male reproductive system that the glands produces alkaline secretion and the prostaglandin, which help in easy movement inside the vagina as well as protect the sperms from acidic conditions. That those acidic conditions are actually due to the presence of these lactobacilli. So these are the bacteria's example, and the pH range is 4 to 5, highly acidic medium, and it prevent from external infections. So these are helpful bacteria present inside the vagina. They appear like this. Now you will find out what is bacterial vaginosis. What is bacterial vaginosis? This is another diagram. These are ovaries. These are fimbri which collect the secondary oocyte. Fallopian tube opens into uterus, walls of uterus, perimetrium, myometrium and inner endometrium. Endometrium highly vascular, fundic part, body part, and this is cervix. Oh, then this cervix opens into vagina, highly folded structure. So these are some extra points. Walls of uterus, outer perimetrium, made up of fibers, thin membranous. Then myometrium, made up of smooth muscles, help in parturition. Inner endometrium, that is highly vascular and undergoes cyclic changes during menstrual cycle. So this is the layer which undergoes cyclic changes during menstrual cycle, highly vascular layer. See, you can easily see the walls of blood pipelines of endometrium are highly folded, spiral arteries, spiral because they can easily provide blood supply in proper amount. Next are the glands. They have Bartholin glands. These are bean-shaped glands situated one each side of the vaginal orifice opening, vaginal opening. And the function is to lubricate the vagina part. And next glands are the mammary glands. These are the mammary glands. Inside the mammary glands, these lobule-like structures are present. Inside these lobules, many alveoli are present. These alveoli opens into a tube-like structure that is termed as lactiferous glands, tubes. From here, the supply of milk is provided. These are the fatty tissues. So these are the two glands associated with it. Now we will see the process of spermatogenesis, how the sperms produced inside the male reproductive unit. As we have already discussed, the germ cells. These were the germ cells which produces spermatogonium. These germ cell produces a spermatogonium. A spermatogonium divide by mitotic division. It is also 2N. These cells are also 2N diploid. Into two types of cells. One again start producing spermatogonium, so that it is a continuous process in case of male. Sperm production is a continuous process in male because of this. Second type of cell start meiosis. After meiosis, one, two cells. These two cells are termed as secondary spermatocyte. After meiosis two, they will produce four cells. These four cells are termed as spermatid. TID, spermatid. These spermatid get differentiated into sperms. So these are the germ cells which produces spermatogonium. These spermatogonium, primary spermatocyte, spermatid, and from spermatid, sperms get differentiated. The phases of the formation of sperm is divided into phase of multiplication, phase of growth, and phase of maturation. Phase of multiplication is the mitotic division. Phase of growth, when the spermatogonia grow in size and become primary spermatocyte. And phase of maturation, primary spermatocyte results into secondary spermatocyte, and secondary spermatocyte results into spermatid. This phase is phase of maturation. This is the structure of spermatid, and these are the sperms. We can easily differentiate between this spermatid and sperm structure. The process of differentiation from spermatid into sperm is termed as spermiogenesis. From spermatid into sperm, metamorphosis is termed as spermiogenesis. So next important question is, what are those changes which occur in spermatid? कौन से वो changes हैं जिनसे spermatid sperm में convert हो जाता है? Those are, spermatid is a non-motile heavy. During metamorphosis, it loses weight. First thing, Golgi complex give rise to acrosome of sperm. This is the acrosome which was formed by Golgi bodies. Nucleus become compact and form the head of sperm. This whole structure is the head of sperm. Locomotory organs develops. We can easily see this tail-like structure. The two centrioles of the spermatid become arranged in sperm as proximal centriole, which is present towards the neck. This is the neck part. Here the proximal centriole is present, and the distal centriole changed into basal body and give rise to axial filament of sperm. This is the distal centriole which form the filaments of this tail part, and the mitochondria becomes spiral. This ribbon like mitochondria is termed as Nebenkern. This is all about the process of formation of sperm in case of males. Inside the ovary, many follicles are present. Now we will see the development of female gamete and all about these follicles, how they form. In case of females, many oogonia were produced during their fetal life in the embryonic time. These oogonia by mitosis differentiated into primary oocyte. This phase is before the birth. After it, first meiotic division starts and they results into formation of but this meiotic division get arrested in the prophase too. After birth during the puberty period, this meiotic division completes and results into secondary oocyte and secondary polar body. This is oogonium. Mitosis starts, results into primary oocyte but get arrested in prophase 1. This meiosis continues, results into formation of secondary oocyte and the polar body but get arrested in the metaphase 2. If the sperm with its centriole enter, then only this meiosis get completed and results into the formation of egg. Otherwise, it will remain in the form of secondary oocyte. So, oogonia by mitotic divisions results into formation of primary oocyte. Then the first meiotic division start after birth but get arrested. After puberty, this first meiotic division starts, results into the formation of secondary oocyte but again get arrested in this stage. Now it will wait for the entry of sperms. If get fertilized, then with the help of centriole, this meiotic division completes and it will form egg. Otherwise, it will remain in the form of this secondary oocyte. This is the structure of ovary. Inside the ovary, many follicles, oogonia, follicles are present. When they are small, they are termed as primary follicle. When they grows in size and large cavity is formed inside them, then they are termed as tertiary follicle, secondary follicles, tertiary follicle. When they again grows in size, form a large cavity, then they are termed as graafian follicle. After this, when this follicle rupture, this secondary oocyte, this is not ovum, this is actually secondary oocyte. This secondary oocyte goes from here. They are collected by these fimbriae of fallopian tube. And the remaining part, the left part, is termed as corpus luteum. This corpus luteum produces hormone progesterone. If fertilization take place, then this corpus luteum persist, and if the fertilization does not occur, then it changes into corpus albicans. You can easily see the difference between secondary follicle, tertiary follicle and the graafian follicle, their size and the cavity present in between. Now the difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Spermatogenesis is the formation of male gamete, sperms. Oogenesis is the formation of female gamete, ovum or the secondary oocyte. Location, testis and ovary. Number of gametes produced, lifelong, throughout the life, fixed. Why? Because they have fixed oogonium. Gamete per germ cell 4 and here only 1. Beginning of the process, it begins at puberty. It starts before birth. Timing of gamete formation, continuous anytime, once in a month. Only one egg is produced, only one secondary oocyte is produced in 1 month. End of the process, fertility is lifelong but reduces. Fertility stops at menopause. Timing of gamete release, can release anytime, once in a month. Meiotic divisions, uninterrupted, arrested They were arrested in prophase 1 and arrested in metaphase 2. Germline epithelium involved in gamete production, not involved in gamete production. Germline means this wall. This was involved in case of the formation of a sperms. So this is all about the spermatogenesis and oogenesis, the structure of female gamete, the structure of female reproductive system, Graafian follicle, secondary follicle, difference between spermatogenesis and oogenesis, development of sperm from spermatid, and the structure of sperm. In the next class, we will talk about the hormonal control. Thank you.